Many years ago, Vicarstown used to be the headquarters of the North Western Railway. But since the agreement with the London, Midland and Scottish Railway was made to use Barrow Station as the main terminus, Vicarstown Yards had no further use. It was then turned into a railway museum, acquired by the North Western Railway Historical Society, and people from far and wide come to see the history of the North Western Railway and see the rare examples of different engines from the past. With some already restored and do rail tours around the mainland to promote the museum, as well as the tourism of Sodor. One day, Thomas was asked to take the kindergarten class of Farquhar Public School to the museum. He was especially excited about the trip because they had just finished repairing an old friend. Glynn! I'm so happy to see you after all these years. Glynn didn't say a word. Instead, he just stared at Thomas. Glynn, what's the matter? Don't you know me? I'm Thomas.
No, replied the coffee pot meekly.
But I'm Thomas. Don't you remember? I was the one who took over the branch line. We used to talk to each other whenever we met at the top station.
But Glynn looked towards his buffers. Well now, I'll tell you a story that'll make your memory better. And this is the story Thomas told him.
Before the North Western Railway was formatted, Glynn used to work on the Tynemouth, Knapford and Ellsbridge Railway, delivering lead from the mines. But years later, in 1924, the line was extended to Farquhar and Anopa Quarry. Glynn was called to take the first train up the slope for a trial run.
Right,
he peeped, and he puffed towards the hill. But Glynn was going slower and slower and slower until he stopped up the hill.
Oh, dear,
he panted.
The old coffee pot has passed it, giggled the trucks.
Glynn was cross. Sir Topham Hatt 1 was on board, and he was not happy.
You're not really satisfactory for this kind of haulage, Glynn.
I'm very sorry, sir.
Don't worry. It's no one's fault. We need a bigger engine to do the workload.
So while the fat controller was looking for an engine, the lorries were taking the stone. But the lorries had proven to the quarry manager that they're much more worthy than an engine. They make their deliveries right on time to their customers.
Glynn was worried. If the roads are taking over, then this branch line would have to close. Oh, I hope Sir Topham Hatt finds another engine soon.
For the time being, Glynn was working on passenger trains. But a bus company was established, and the buses were taking his passengers, as they found it was faster than Glynn's passenger runs. Glynn tried to be more reliable than the buses. But he ended up breaking down. His boiler cracked and he sprang a leak. With the lack of money for his repairs, thanks to the lack of passengers and goods traffic, he was left in the sidings at Farquhar rusting away. He stayed there for days and days and worried for the future of the branch line. Then, one sunny day, he saw some passengers at the station.
What are they doing here? There's no train.
Then he heard an engine puffing into view. It was a large blue tank engine with two coaches behind him and a big yellow number one on one of his side tanks. He looked towards the coffee pot.
Oh, you must be the new number one.
I'm Thomas.
Well, look after the punchline, Thomas, and wear that number with pride.
Don't worry, Mr. Coffee Pot. I will. You could count on me.
But, my name's not Mr. Coffee Pot.
My name is Glynn.
It looks as though the future is safe. But for how long?
Thomas was trying his best to run his branch line, but he had many flaws along the way. Leaving the guard behind, having a fish clogging his pee pipe in his boiler, and getting stuck in the snow when it was rescued by Terrence the tractor. He felt bad about what had happened, as there weren't many passengers after the road vehicles called him out on them. A really useful engine, they say. More like he's a really useless engine, teased one of the new buses, and he laughed away. Thomas parked alongside Glynn, feeling very miserable.
What's the matter, Thomas?
Running a branch line is difficult. I'd rather be back as a station pilot. I get no complaints from passengers in those road vehicles. I'm not really useless there.
Well, you can't be good at first try, Thomas. A branch line is more difficult than shunting in the yards. It's a huge responsibility to keep, and Sir Topham does have his reasons for you. Keep doing the best you can. Sir Topham sees you as a really useful engine. So try and be really useful and make this an important part of the whole railway.
Thomas's confidence boosted up. All right, I will.
At the quarry, there was a big load of stone that needed to be taken to the harbour. Some of the lorries were called, but the shipment needed to be shipped today. The lorries tried their best, but the country road was quite difficult, and some were broken down and clogging up traffic. So Thomas was called, and he backed up to the trucks.
Don't leave our guard behind, Thomas, teased the trucks.
Don't leave us behind like you did in Henry's coaches, said another. Shush, you lot. I know this engine, and he was the one who bumped us after James's accident. But Thomas didn't care, as he gave them a bump. It made the trucks very quiet after that.
When all the trucks were loaded, Thomas pulled them out of the yards and he puffed his way to the harbour.
Well done, Thomas. Keep it up.
And ever since that day, more trucks were filled. Then, as time went on, more passengers came, thanks to a certain race. Glynn was restored thanks to the money that was made.
Ah, it's good to move my wheels again. Thank you, Thomas.
Glynn was mostly used as a spare engine as the years passed. Whenever Thomas is ill or busy elsewhere, Glynn did his work for him to keep the line running.
Does that jog your memory? But like earlier, the embarrassed Glynn just said,
No.
Then Alice spoke up.
Thomas, she began, I'm sure you know what happened in 1951.
No? Why?
Well, I'll tell you what manager told us last night.
And this is the story. There was another big order of stone to be delivered, and Glynn was to take the stone to the harbour.
Right, off we go then, he said.
As he disembarked towards the steep hill, he noticed that he was going faster and faster.
"Driver, stop!"
he yelled.
"Don't worry, Glynn," his driver shouted. He applied the brakes, but they were weak against the surging trucks. He then put every ounce of weight and steam against the trucks. Still nothing. He was out of control.
"Help!"
he yelled.
He whistled to warn a plate layer to turn towards the runaway siding, but he was too late. And Glynn dashed through the top station. The signalman received the message and switched Glynn to a pair of bucklers in a siding near Maithwaite.
"Look out!"
he whistled. Luckily, he stopped. But the impact of the crash was so big that stone of the train flew out and battered him and his boiler in very bad shape. Toby was puffing past with his passengers.
"Glynn!"
he rang. He raced as fast as he could towards the next station, and in no time at all, Percy arrived at the breakdown crane. As Glynn was placed on the tracks, he was in a very sorry state.
"Oh, Glynn, I'm ever so sorry," said Percy mournfully.
He shunted the coffee pot engine all the way back to Ellsbridge. He stayed there for days, feeling cold, lonely, and miserable. Sir Charles Topham Hatt, the son of Sir Topham Hatt I, came to see him looking very sad.
"I can't believe I'm saying this to my father's creation, but Glynn, you're uneconomical for your repairs, and so you'll be sent for scrap. I wish you were given proper breaks soon."
This Glynn you see now is a replica version of him. The museum wants to showcase what coffee pot engines are like.
"A replica?"
"Yes, it's true," replied the replicated Glynn.
Thomas's heart sank. I don't believe you." And he puffed away to a siding.
Thomas returned to the big station later in the day. Bertie the bus was assigned to take the school children home, and Thomas was to settle the night at the sheds outside the station. But he was still upset over the story of Glynn.
"He can't be a replica," he huffed. Then he saw the fat controller leaving his office for the day. He then spotted Thomas.
"Thomas, how was the school excursion today?"
"It was good, sir," sighed Thomas.
"Whatever is the matter, Thomas? You look glum."
"Well, sir, I was talking to one of the museum engines that's called Glynn, and Alice told me that he is a replica. Just wondering, sir, is it true, sir?"
"Yes, Thomas, it is true."
Thomas felt shocked. "But, sir,
Why wasn't I told?
Well, my great-grandfather knows how close you and Glynn were and how he had helped you to become a success on your branch line. So he didn't want to hurt your feelings, but he regretted scrapping Glynn and kept you under wraps from you. I hope you can forgive him, Thomas. Glynn was just beyond repaired, and even the museum couldn't fix him at the time.
But Thomas didn't say anything. He just puffed sadly away. That night, while all the other engines were asleep, Thomas couldn't stop thinking about Glynn and his fate. He then yawned and fell to sleep. Thomas puffed into Ellsbridge Yards, and there he found Glynn.
Glynn, I'm so happy to see you.
And I as well, Thomas.
Glynn, I can save you. You will be given proper breaks and be repaired.
No, Thomas.
Why not?
I'm an old engine, and I can't be repaired anymore. I realized that my time had come and must retire from service. I had a good long run of this railway, and must give away for the younger engines.
But the museum now can repair you.
I'm fine with that replica version of me. He's represented me for what I've done in the past, and you, Thomas, just have to deal with that. He's only a young engine. Please, Thomas, don't be hard on him just because he isn't really me.
Well, okay.
And don't blame this on Sir Richard Topham Hatt or his grandfather, Thomas. He regretted keeping all this a secret from you. You must forgive them if they learn their mistakes.
Thomas knew Glynn was right.
Well, time that I'll be off.
I'll miss you, Glynn. Thank you for everything. And goodbye.
I'll miss you too, Thomas. And goodbye. And thank you for saving the branch line.
Dawn arrived, and before Thomas headed for his branch line, he offered to take the morning goods as far as Vicarstown as the yards over in Barrow were being replaced with new railway tracks. Before he left, he told the Fat Control that he was sorry for being angry towards him the other night. And after he delivered the goods, he went into the yards of the Railway Museum and pulled towards the museum engines.
I was just thinking about Glynn here. I realize that the one I know is no longer here with us. But this one, I'm glad to say, is carrying on his spirit for who and what he is. So, no, I won't be living in denial, and will realize that my old friend is gone for good because of his costly repairs. So, Glynn, I hope you carry on and give him credit.
I will, Thomas. Thank you.
And Thomas puffed home, thinking about his legendary friend, Glynn, the coffee pot engine.